One of the most interesting questions in all of medicine is why certain people, in other words, certain personalities, have certain illnesses. Have you ever wondered that? Like, why do some people end up being more prone to anxiety, more prone to depression, more prone to headaches, or more prone to never getting headaches, no matter how sick they are or how many colds they get? Why is that? Now, in this video, I want to share what I think is the third self-healing principle I realized recovering and healing myself from chronic illness, which is something that relates to the inner game, which is your beliefs and your own particular worldview about life. So let's jump in and talk about this third self-healing principle. Hey, I'm Alex Heyne, current doctoral student in traditional or classical Chinese medicine, also author of the book Master the Day. Now, I've included a beginner's guide to Chinese medicine. It's how to add 10 years to your life. It's a cool little printout cheat sheet. It's the first link in the description to download it. So you can click that link, download it, and check it out. That'll be delivered right to your email. So this third self-healing principle is not a physical material principle, a habit, but it's a habit of thinking, and it's a habit in the sense of a worldview habit. It's the way we habitually view the world and our lives that honestly is more illness producing and illness causing than many other habits and beliefs that are invisible. Okay? The belief and the habit is that I am a victim of life. Now, I first started noticing this in a lot of patients while I've still been in school, and some of them have the same conditions. They have serious chronic pain, serious chronic disease, and some are dealing with it better than others. Some are turning on the blame button. Oh, this is happening to me, and this, and this, and then this happened to me, and then this, and this, this. Like, everywhere drips of victimization, drips of blaming the world and the universe for all these bad things everyone did to me. And it's kind of interesting, because one thing is for certain. If we're blaming the whole world, and we're acting and feeling like victims, we probably will not try much to change. And let me elaborate on this more. So one of the things I notice a lot with conventional biomedicine is that it tends to result in us as patients blaming a lot about the outside and not blaming ourselves. So for example, we say things like, you know, oh, it's just genetics, or I got this infection from swimming in the Amazon, or, you know, I had bad food quality growing up, or this is something else that happened to me. And the problem is that may be true. That may be true. But the healing lies in the solution. What are you going to do about it? What are you going to change? What are you going to improve? How are you going to live differently so this doesn't happen again? Or that this does go away? Like, how do you need to live differently to heal? It's true in relationships where you see people say, you know, I always date the messed up guy. I always date the messed up girl. And it still is the victim thing. Like, what is wrong with me that always makes me do this? Well, guess what? It's, of course, easy to blame the world. It's very easy to blame life when something goes wrong. And even though something may have happened outside of you that caused that, at the end of the day, we still need to change something or improve something. If we are the sick person and there's something with diet, lifestyle, intervention, something else, medicine that we can do, we need to do that. If we are the person that has issues and we keep dating other people like us that have issues, we need to change that. Now, we could also say this about things like money. Right? There's so much blame around money. Oh, it's my student loans. My parents did this, didn't do this. It's the government. It's this new president. It's the time and it's just like the nonstop blame, the refrain. But you know what really happy, healthy, successful people are doing? They're not blaming, complaining. They may have had hard lives too, even harder lives. And yet they're solution focused. So what am I going to do about it? So here's what I want to leave you with as this self-healing affirmation and principle, and more importantly, habit. I want you to take something like a piece of paper near your computer, near your desk, something you can review, and write down this little affirmation. If for 100 days I lived as if I am not a victim of life, you are powerful beyond measure, you have the same consciousness and ability to change as the creator of the universe, what would happen if you lived that way today and every day for the next 100 days? So I want you to just do a thought experiment. Because the difference is, when you act like a victim, There's literally nothing more poisonous and more toxic, and nothing that renders you impotent more than that belief. Because that, more than anything, guarantees you will not try, you will not change, because you don't believe it will do anything. So consider that. This is really important because you are a powerful creator in charge of improving and healing your life. Despite often what statistics may say, there's always a certain number of even spontaneous remissions of advanced medical illnesses. So this is something really important to keep in mind, and it's something that takes time. So I hope that helps. That is self-healing principle number 3 that has helped me quite a lot. Again, to download the guide on how to add 10 years to your life with Chinese medicine, click that first link, download that guide. You can also check out my last 2 videos right there and right there.